Now let us talk about how to remove ACLs from a given file or directory. So you can actually run Hadoop fs-help setfscl to get the details. So we still have to use setfscl command itself to remove the ACLs also. You can either use -b or -k or -x for different purposes when it comes to removing the access. So -b will remove all but the base ACL entries. -k remove the default ACL. If you want to just remove from a particular user, you can use -x. All other ACLs with respect to other users and groups will be removed. So for example, in this case, if you switch to Cloudera and run Hadoop fs get facl on user Cloudera acls demo.txt, you see the user ITversity have read write permissions. Apart from him, no one else have read write permissions on this. Let's actually set acl. And give write access for user demo also on this file, user Cloudera acls demo.txt. Now, if you look at output of getfacl, even demo will have read and write permissions. You can see here. Now, if I want to just remove access from user demo, I can say Hadoop fs setfacl -x and then user demo and then give the path of the file, which is nothing but user Cloudera acls demo.txt. Now user demo will lose access on this file. You can actually see the output of getfacl to review. Only ITversity have read write access. If you want to completely remove all ACLs from this file or directory, you can actually say -b, which will not take any arguments such as username, group name, etc. And all the ACLs on ACLs demo.txt will be gone. You can confirm by running Hadoop fs get facl on top of this file. Even user ITversity will lose the access. In the previous run of get facl, we have read write access for user ITversity on this file, user Cloudera acls demo.txt. Now the user ITversity lost the access on user Cloudera acls demo.txt. Okay, so this is how you can use -b to remove all the ACLs except for the base entries from a file or directory. Now if you just want to remove the default one, so if you recollect and if you actually run our getfacl on acls demo, it has default also. So if you want to remove the default, if you say setfacl -b and remove this extension and hit enter, and then run getfacl on this, it will not only remove the defaults, but also it will remove the original permissions for user ITversity on this directory. However, if you just want to remove default without impacting the direct access for the users on a file or directory, for example, in the case of subdir, you can see that there is a default here, but there is no access for other users also. If there is access to other users, let us take care of that also. So let me say setfacl -m user ITversity read, write, and execute on this. So on subdirectory, now user ITversity will have read, write, execute permissions. You can confirm by saying getfacl on this. Now let's say I want to just delete the default without removing access to user ITversity. Then I can say Hadoop fs -setfacl -k and then the directory on which the default ACL should be deleted. So if you want to delete all ACLs, you use -b. If you just want to delete default one without touching the direct ACLs for users or groups, you use -k. If you want to remove permissions or ACLs for a given user, you use -x. Okay, now you see user IT bus still have read write execute permissions on subdirectory, but the defaults are gone. Okay, so these are different variations of using setfacl to remove access of using ACLs from a user or group or others.